Hey, what's up, guys? Hope everyone out there is doing well. My name is Mike, and we're about to get into a reaction for the film Sleepers from 1996. So this one is a request. This one's going to be for Kay. This is a movie that... Well, let me just read what she said. This is from Kay. She said, this movie's kind of heavy. I think you can handle it. Okay, so I'm assuming that means... Well, I did ask her, is this a drama? What is this? Is this a drama or a horror? And she said she's not sure how it would be classified. There's a little bit of courtroom drama action. So, yeah, I'm guessing emotional. It's going to be heavy emotionally. So, yeah, I'm excited for this. This one has a lot of big names in it. Just looking here from Google, Kevin Bacon, Brad Renfro, Jason Patrick, Billy Crudup. I hope I'm saying that right. Brad Pitt, Ron Eldred. I think I saw him in Deep Impact, I think it was. I'm not sure. And then also Robert De Niro, she said, was in it. I don't know why he's not even showing up as one of the top actors here. Maybe it's... Ah, there he is. He was the last one. Okay. So, yeah, I've pretty much seen all these actors in something before, except for Brad Renfro. I can't remember... The name's familiar. Like, I know he's a guy that he passed away. He left us too soon. It might have been drugs. I'm not sure. But I can't really pinpoint anything else he's been in. But everyone else... You know, I've seen him in something. So Brad Pitt, obviously, he's been in a million movies. Kevin Bacon, Jason Patrick, I saw him in Lost Boys. Billy Crudup, Watchmen, I saw him in Watchmen, amongst probably a bunch of other things that I just can't place right now. But anyway, I'm excited for this. I'm going into this one pretty blind. I'm still not quite sure what this one's about, other than it being heavy. So again, this is a request for Kay. Get yourself a drink or a snack. And let's do this. Let's get into Sleepers from 1996. Here we go. Okay, rated R. You know, I mentioned this. I put a little warning at the beginning of every video, but even if a movie's rated R, this channel is not, unfortunately. So I usually have to edit out or blur some of the more graphic stuff and cursing and stuff. Barry Levinson. She also mentioned that. It was directed by Barry Levinson. I've probably seen more that this guy has done because his name's familiar, but I can't think of anything off the top of my head. Hey, Dustin Hoffman, too. All right. Yeah, this one's a long one, man. It said 2 hours and 27 minutes.
This is a true story about friendship that runs deeper than blood. This is my story and that of the only three friends in my life who truly mattered. Two of them were killers who never made it past the age of 30. The other is a non-practicing attorney living with the pain of his past, never confronting its horror. I'm the only one who could speak for them, and the children we were.
Okay. I thought I heard that, like, Bird is the Word song in the background. It probably was something else, though. Oh, man. I had to hear this song a lot growing up when I was a kid. I'm 41 years old now, so my parents were into stuff like this, as well as things a little bit in later eras. Wait, when was this? Did it say? I must have missed it when I was talking. 66, okay. Sorry about that. I've seen that kid second on the left in some other movies, too.
Hell's Kitchen. The west side streets of Manhattan were our private playground. Hell's Kitchen was populated by an uneasy blend of Irish, Italian, Puerto Rican, and Eastern European laborers.
Wonder how much water was wasted from people, like kids, doing that back in the day in the city.
I buried one f***ing wife, I can bury another one.
I've seen that guy before. He has a very unique voice, too.
Yet there was no divorce and few separations. The will of the church was forceful. For a marriage to end, someone usually had to die.
I can relate to that.
Crimes against people of the neighborhood were not permitted. When they did occur, the punishment doled out was severe. A drug dealer from an uptown neighborhood moved heroin in the Hell's Kitchen. The packet killed a 12-year-old son of a Puerto Rican numbers runner. It was the last packet the dealer ever sold.
Take matters into their own hands.
We each served as altar boys. There was an active competition between the four of us to come up with the best and boldest prank. I found the nun's clacker in the school hallway.
Clacker?
It was used to alert the girls as to when they should stand, sit, kneel, and genuflect.
Oh no. Oh no.
It will be a great day. Of the Holy Spirit.
How do they can't tell where it's coming from? Oh, he knows.
Well, it's going to be a great day.
Man, he's young there too, by the way.
Let me have a clacker.
What kind?
Now.
Oh, he did it too. Oh, man. Okay. He's got a sense of humor.
And John and I were intrigued by the powers a priest was given, where people openly admitted dark misdeeds and vile indiscretions. Confession was better than any book we could get our hands on or any movie we could see.
We get caught, don't burn us. What if our mother's right there?
Man, it's a short kid.
I sleep with married men. In the morning, I tell myself it's the last time, but never is. I'm pregnant.
What are you going to do?
I know what I should do. I just don't know what I'm gonna do. Look, I gotta go. Thanks for listening, fellas. I really appreciate it.
Oh, man. She knew. Oh, wow.
Yeah, she knows.
That's crazy.
I think she told us all that.
She needed to talk to somebody, man.
Father Robert Carrillo was a longshoreman's son.
Oh, good vibrations in the background.
He had toyed with the life of petty crime before finding his calling. He was a friend.
I hear you're interested in becoming a priest. Word is you want to get the feel of a confessional book.
Oh, he knew too.
Well, maybe I got the wrong information.
I guess you did.
I'll see you later tonight.
What's tonight?
I gotta drop some books and magazines off for the elderly and disabled around the neighborhood. Your mother said you loved to help.
Yeah, I bet she did.
Hey, you gotta pay for what your consequences.
I don't want you getting in any trouble. That's all I wish for you and your friends.
That's it?
That's it. Nothing else, I swear. That's it.
No, I appreciate it, swear.
The kids shouldn't be listening to other people's confessions. I'll see you tonight.
The movie just started, but De Niro's character is real personable.
His real love was Carol Martinez. She was raised by her father, her mother having died at childbirth.
Ah, that's a beautiful bridge. Big contrast to the rest of the city.
We could always count on Carol to stand sentry on the first night of the escapade.
Really? Oh my god. And the chick is helping him do this?
What?
Oh,
Hey, Carol, you want to take a look? I think it's something I haven't seen.
Okay.
When my friends and I were young, Hell's Kitchen was run by a man named King Benny.
When he was young, King Benny was a hitman for Lucky Luciano. Lucky Luciano did a lot of good for this country during World War II.
Did he now?
I was 14 when I first heard about him. As a kid, he wasn't much of anything. And then one day, some Irish guy about 25 years old, he takes King Benny and he flings him down a flight of stairs. King Benny breaks all his teeth in the front. You know what King Benny does? He waits 8 years to get even with that prick. He walks into a public bathhouse. The guy's soaking in the tub. King Benny takes out his front teeth, lays him down on the sink. Then he looks over at the guy and he says, "When I look in the mirror, I see your face." Then he pulls out a gun and he shoots the guy twice in each leg. Bang, bang! Bang, bang!
I'm not laughing at the situation. I'm laughing at them using him saying bang, bang instead of a gunshot noise.
No one ever f***ed with King Benny after that. Revenge.
Wow, only back in the 60s and 70s, maybe even the 80s, could a dad sit there with his son and like a couple friends and with reverence them listening to him talk about a mobster like that. You know, most parents nowadays wouldn't even want to tell their kids about something like this.
I'd like to work for you, help you out, whatever you need.
You're the butcher's kid. What kind of job are you looking for?
Whatever, it doesn't matter.
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Everybody says this place come for jobs.
Who is everybody?
People from the neighborhood.
The f- do they know?
Is that Kennedy in the background there? You had a picture of Kennedy on the wall?
Hold on a sec.
Yeah?
Come back tomorrow if you want to work.
Okay. I mean, it's probably a bad thing, him getting involved in this stuff, though, huh?
First job for King Benny paid $25 a week and ate up only 40 minutes of my time. One of the guys would hand me a crumpled paper bag and direct me to one of the two local police precincts for delivery.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Come on. Let's go! Right here.
You know you're taking off?
Yeah, we don't always get this.
You're back!
Hey, what'd you do then?
Relax. This time he took my money.
You took the money from the boy? Let me have the bag. You. Oh, yeah? How about now?
All right.
Ooh. Ah, you're not smart anymore. Now you just make you stupid.
Oh, I seen that guy. Now on the go. Right.
Go! Go, run!
Oh, shh.
Lift the old guy and show him.
What you need?
Oh, he shot him, man.
Your friends.
These kids you can trust. I've known them half my life.
Father Bobby knew my friends and I worked for King Benny and he wasn't pleased. He wasn't worried about the pocket money, but the next step, when they asked you to pick up a gun.
Yeah.
He didn't want that to happen to us.
I found an art class for you to take.
No, I can't afford to take any art classes.
Well, you don't have to pay anything. The teacher's a friend of mine. Could be the first step.
First step to what?
doing something with your life.
Guys, are we gonna talk or play basketball?
Yeah, he really cares about these kids.
Michelangelo. He was born poor just like you guys. He was a painter, he was a sculptor. He takes his job from the Pope. The Pope was looking for the best guy he could find to paint the ceiling of his church in Rome.
Sistine Chapel.
That way he could pay off the loan sharks that were chasing his father down.
What's his father?
Low-level con guy.
Or was he just trying to make this more relatable to them?
You know what it was? You know what it was? The Sistine Chapel.
16th Chapel?
16th Chapel. All right, 1 year has went by.
In a society changing radically by the hour, we watch the images scatter nightly.
Vietnam.
My friends and I went to funeral services for the young men of Hell's Kitchen.
Oh, boy. Okay, this movie is still just in the beginning, but I'm really liking where this one's going. And, you know, I didn't know what to expect, but so far, it's quite enjoyable.
We sat with Father Bobby in a third-floor hospital ward visiting John, hoping he recovered from a punctured lung, a gift from one of his mother's overzealous boyfriends.
Oh, jeez. Oh, that's messed up, man.
Father Bobby didn't let that situation rest.
I was just thinking if he was going to do anything.
It was a slap. Enough.
A slap that resulted in a punctured lung?
And you won't need a doctor when I'm done. You'll need a priest to pray over your body.
Ooh, which I can also do. I'll kill you and I'll pray for you.
Father Bobby would have made a good hitman. It's a shame we lost him to the other side.
We were down 7-6 in the last inning of a sewer-to-sewer stickball game against Hector Maldonado and three of his friends.
Take this chump out! He got nothing!
Who's that?
Sister.
What happened to her?
Kind of cancer got on the legs or something. Worry about the
game. You can take him, Mikey. Yeah, I told you it wasn't, baby.
Didn't have to throw the game. Now with a Salvation on.
That was nice of him to do that for her.
You let him be. Because Iris here has a thing for little girls with no legs. You boys are soft like bread. It's going to catch up to you.
This is cool how, like, the neighborhood, everyone knows each other here, even though you're in a big city, you know?
In his mind, losing that game and handing a feeling of victory to a girl in a wheelchair was more than the right thing to do.
Catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world.
Temperature topped out at 98 degrees on the day our lives were forever altered.
Ooh, we're getting to, a climax of this part of the story.
It's a happy.
We haven't hit the hot dog vend in a couple of weeks.
I don't know, Mikey. A cock guy ain't like the other.
We can eat hot dogs, we can eat it.
Who's two? Yours.
Don't they make like $25 a week between them working for the other guy? Why do they have to steal it? The
scam was simple. Vendor would then hand me my hot dog and watch as I ran off without paying. He could stand his ground and swallow his loss, or he could give chase.
Oh, man. Oh, that's... Oh, I feel bad for that guy. Oh, man, I hope this guy doesn't get hit by a car. Oof.
Think we can push it, the three of us?
Why?
Push it where?
A couple of blocks. Be a nice surprise for the guy not to find his car.
Oh, man. The kids should just take the food and go.
I'm fast, Mike.
Still here?
Go!
What? Just leave it.
We were to hold the cart on the top edge of the stairwell, leaning it downward, and wait for the vendor. We were to let it go the second he grabbed the handle. To this day, I don't know why we did it, but we would all pay a price.
Oh, that's so, like, they can run away without him chasing them. Is he dead? Holy crap. Oh my god, man.
What in the name of God have you boys done?
Holy crap. Oh, they messed up big time, man.
While James Caldwell was slowly recovering at St. Clair's Hospital,
oh, he lived.
We were charged with reckless endangerment.
Sorry, Dad.
Ain't gonna do you much good.
Take it easy.
You're going to jail and you don't even know what the f*** that means. Nobody in his family should have to do time. I done enough time for everybody.
Oh, gosh. Are they going to do time, though? I mean, they'd have to be tried as adults. They're pretty young. Wow, that's a messed up situation, man. Hold on. Okay, so, you know, When I saw what happened earlier, one of the first things I was thinking that was running through my head is how stupid this was. Like, this was stupid. But I have to remember, you know, even back to my childhood, when I was that age, I had three best friends, just like these guys. We did stupid stuff all the time. So I'm a little bit more understanding of it now, in this moment, than I was watching that happen earlier. But yeah, what a stupid thing. And you know, it's part of growing up, you know, sadly. I'm not saying everyone is this stupid and has a situation like this serious in their past, but I can understand it.
I hear you showed an altar boy.
You still remember what to do?
He said, I only want you the best for you kids. I want you to stay out of trouble.
I could run. Nobody's gonna come looking. Nobody's gonna care about us.
Hiding is not gonna make it go away. People aren't gonna forget. You've gotta face this.
That's true.
Again, Father. I don't wanna face it.
That's too bad, buddy.
I'm scared to face it.
It's gonna be scary then, but you gotta do it.
But you gotta do it.
You gotta pay for your mistakes. That's fair. You know, you almost killed the guy, so this is fair.
This is one of my favorites. Whatever you do to the least of my brethren, you do to me.
That's actually a really good quote, and it could go both ways. It's like, whatever you do to the least of my brethren, you do to me. It's like them messing with a guy. It hurts him. It hurts humanity. When you hurt one person, the rest of humanity hurts. And then on the other side, another way to look at it is them punishing the kids for what they did. He feels it too. You know? That's kind of cool. Double entendre there. Double meaning.
We never saw the vendor as a man. Not the way we saw the men of the neighborhood. And we didn't care enough about him to grant him any respect.
Mm-hmm.
We gave little notice to how hard he worked. Or that he had a wife and two kids in Greece and hoped to bring them to this country. We didn't pay attention to the long hours he worked. We didn't see any of that.
Thomas Marcano, the court hereby sentences you to be remanded for a period of no... at the Wilkinson Home for Boys.
I forgot that there was even, you know, juvenile detention centers.
I might add, had it not been for the intervention of Father Robert Carrillo, who spoke in glowing terms on your behalf, would have sentenced you to a much stiffer punishment. I still have my doubts as to your inherent goodness. Only time will serve to prove me wrong.
No matter what you hear, tell him I'm doing okay.
You want me to lie?
It's a good lie, Father. You can do it.
Come on, let's go.
Be strong.
Oh boy, man, this is the beginning of the movies, and I know it's a long movie, so this is probably gonna be a good chunk of the film here. Them being in this detention center, this is probably not gonna be awesome. I don't think I've ever seen a movie like this that focuses on a juvenile detention center.
The Wilkinson Home for Boys held 780 youthful offenders. From the outside, the facility resembled what those who ran it wanted it to resemble, some kind of nice school or university. We each had a private 12-foot room. I'd been in my room less than an hour when the panic set in. It doesn't take very long to know how tough a person you are or how strong you can be. I knew from my first day at Wilkinson that I was neither tough nor strong.
You know, my first day in boot camp, when I used to be in the military, when I joined, I had a feeling like that once we got to our bunks and we actually finally had a moment to kind of collect our thoughts before we had to, you know, do something else. It was starting to set in too. I didn't start to panic probably as bad as him being in a prison, but I was definitely thinking to myself, like, what the heck have I gotten myself into? So I can kind of relate to that a little bit.
Hello, Carcaterra.
Oh boy, Kevin Bacon.
Toss your clothes on the floor.
Yeah?
What are you expecting, a dressing room? We don't have any.
In front of you?
Let's go, let's go. It's that piece of shit around your neck. Take it off.
It's Mary, the mother of God.
I don't give a f*** whose mother it is. Take it off.
I'm guessing he's not going to be a good dude in this.
Everything.
Do you want me to stand here naked?
Now you're catching on. I knew you Hell's Kitchen boys weren't as dumb as everyone says.
Oh no, that look, that's not good.
Now what?
Get dressed.
Oh no, he is a freaking chimo, man.
There were four guards assigned to each floor. It was was not a group of innocent young boys at Wilkinson. Most, if not all, the inmates belong there. And as for rehabilitation, forget it.
Man, these kids are on the little end, too, compared to some of these other kids. This is like prison. Oh. Really? Already?
What the f*** you do that for?
I don't want to be near you or your creeped out friends.
That's a big kid. Ooh. Oh, he doesn't care about the size either. Yeah, help him. Help your buddy. Look at that dirtbag just watching it. I've never seen Kevin Bacon really play an asshole like this guy. Like a bad guy like this.
You know your time here hasn't taught you sh**. You're still the same f***ing bunch of clowns you were the day you walked in. Finish your lunches. There's nothing more to see. Go on.
Look at this. They all listened immediately after he whistled. I seen this other guy too, by the way. He's in a show called Oz.
You Hell's Kitchen boys get any lunch?
I got to smell it.
You got to smell it. That's good. Hey, where you going? You boys don't need to get back in line to get lunch. There's plenty to eat right where you're staying.
Oh, dude.
You can smell it.
Oh my, what a...
I'm not hungry.
Well, I don't give a f*** if you're hungry or not. You eat cause I'm telling you to eat.
I'm still not hungry.
Jeez.
I'll tell you when you're hungry or not. I eat.
Dude, these are kids.
Get the f*** down on your knees now and finish your goddamn lunch! Got some mashed potatoes. Come on, suck up some of that jello. Come on, don't be thinking you got all day. Hurry up, come on. Hey, look, boy, see how he follows my rules?
Shift's over, Noakes.
I'm not ready to go yet. I still got a few more things I gotta clean up here.
I'll clean what needs cleaning.
Stay out of this one. It's got nothing to do with you.
I'm staying in.
Good. There's one guard who's not a complete...
Don't f*** with me, boy.
Oh, really?
No, Noakes. You f*** with me. I'm asking you.
Ooh. That's right, bitch.
I'll get out of your way. For now.
I'll take what I can get.
There's one guard here who's
boys
not...
Boys, get off your knees.
Who's not a piece of... garbage. Man, this makes everything so much worse that he's doing this and hitting them. It's one thing if you're abusing prisoners like that, adult prisoners, but these are kids, man.
I don't understand you boys. I don't think you know what it means to have rules. You gotta have rules and you gotta have discipline. Well, I don't know what it was like in your homes and your home lives, but in my house with my father, there were rules. And if you didn't follow the rules, there was hell to pay.
Where the hell are they going? This can't be something that's sanctioned. What the f***? Something f*** is about to happen here.
You too.
This is gonna sound weird, because both of these are bad, but I hope it's just them about to get hit or something versus what I'm the other thing I'm thinking.
There's no one to interrupt us here now.
Oh, God.
What do you want?
What?
Down on your knees.
What the f- Oh my god!
Face the wall. Face!
I can't believe this is what's happening. I can't believe this. This is... I did not expect this. Oh my god. Okay. You said this was gonna be heavy, but wow.
I buried it as deep as it can possibly go. It was my 14th birthday.
Oh god. Oh my god, man, I was so messed up.
Noakes warned us not to say anything to Father Bobby. If we did, reprisals would be severe. I love Father Bobby, but I couldn't stand to look at him. I was afraid he'd look right through me.
Is there anything you want to tell me?
You shouldn't come here anymore, Father.
Man, I can't believe I'm seeing Kevin Bacon play a role like this, too.
I'm on my way up here to see an old friend of mine. We were both sent up here. And it wasn't easy. Just like it's not easy for you and the guys. This place killed him. Made him not care anymore. Don't let this place do that to you, Shakes.
I gotta go, Father.
I wonder if his experience, though, when he was a kid, was as bad as theirs. Man, Father Bobby.
I didn't want to let him go.
He's the man.
Never felt as close to anyone as I felt him that moment.
He's like a father for all four of these kids. In some ways better than, you know, their fathers.
The sounds of pained anguish. Those cries can change the course of a life. They are cries that on this one night, those cries belonged to my friend John when Ralph Ferguson paid him a visit.
Oh, God, dude. That is insane that this is still going on. Like, not a single parent has been able to, speak up. Just no one's telling their parents.
I want to help you.
You may not believe that, or you may not care, but it's the truth.
Hey, was that dude from Mad Men?
You did a great job on your book report. You really seemed to like the book, Count of Monte Cristo. Did you get a copy of the book at home?
Not the Classics Illustrated comic.
It's not the same thing.
I had a request on my main YouTube channel to do a reaction to that movie. Sadly, I forgot about that request until now. Maybe I should get it up on the channel sometime soon.
It's my way of saying thanks.
For what?
That somebody listens, even if it's just one student.
Good. There's another, one other good person in there. Yeah, that Mr. Carlson. I think he was the guy from Mad Men.
Here's your locker
room. Oh my God.
It was only a game. Just a touch football game. Nothing more. But a game I wish we had never played. Guards against inmates. We had a 2-hour practice. Didn't matter much. We weren't supposed to win. Michael saw an opening. A chance to bring the game to our level. He needed Rizzo.
On Saturday, we can hit back. And beating them on Saturday, it's not gonna change a thing.
Then why, white boy, why?
To make them feel what we feel. Just for a couple of hours.
Nah, don't try anything funny, Sambo.
Oh, man. Wow, I can't believe they even do this.
You're gonna die.
There's no way that this would even be allowed, at least today. Like prisoners versus prison guards.
I'm feeling good today. This feels good.
This is insane. A little bit hard to believe here, but I mean, it was like the 60s, so I guess it's believable.
For those 90 minutes. We were once again free.
I mean, we already saw he was in that little solitary confinement thing, so they beat their asses.
For once, we had a victory, but it didn't last. And all I wanted to do was die.
There's a rat right there. What the heck? It's so used to people, too. Just openly walking around. Oh, wow. Oh, that was a cool little effect there.
John and Tommy are on the other side there.
God, this isn't just... This is crazy.
Rizzo. They killed him.
Oh my God.
They took turns beating him until there was nothing of that kid to beat.
Oh my gosh, man.
Rizzo was dead because of us. We made him think that going up against the guards in a meaningless football game had some value, that it would give us a reason to go on once again.
Yes, this is freaking heavy, man. Wow. This is so crazy. Just as bad as a prison. Just as bad as an adult prison, man.
When I get out, I could get Father Bobby and make a couple phone calls.
There's nothing to talk about.
There's a lot to talk about.
I don't want anybody to know.
That's
not
why.
Not Father Bobby, King Benny, not my mother, nobody.
That's why it's been able to go on this long.
I wouldn't know what to say to anyone who did know.
Either they won't believe it, or I won't give a
This is exactly what the Me Too movement was all about, man.
So might as well not even talk about it. The truth stays with us.
I want to be able to sleep one night and not have to worry who's coming in my room. What's going to happen to me?
Yeah, they just pop in on you guys, man. That's sick. That's so sick.
I was in my last hours as an inmate at the Wilkinson Home for Boys. I was given 4 copies of my release form. I never heard the key turn in the lock. And
oh,
I never heard
God.
The snap of the bolt.
I just wanted to say goodbye.
I told him right to his face. I said, I don't care if you're paying the overtime or not. I'm not working those kind of hours. Yeah, but it's
dude. This moment, it's so routine for them to do this. They're just complaining about their jobs while leading the kids there. That's unbelievably messed up, man. Oh my God. And all 4 of those freaking guards are part of this, man.
A night that will never be removed from my mind. June 1st, 1968, the summer of love. The last night at the Wilkinson Home for Boys.
This is so freaking horrible. Going through any tunnels like that the rest of my life after this would probably traumatize me. Oh wow. Wow, we fast forward. Hey, there's that Ron Eldred dude and Billy Crudup. I thought we were going to spend the rest of the movie inside that place.
At 8:25 p.m., two men walked through the doors. The bartender knew their faces, as most of the neighborhood knew their names. They were two of the founding members of the West Side Boys. They were also its deadliest. The blonde-haired man had been in and out of jail since he was a teenager. He was presently a suspect in four unsolved homicides. The dark-haired man was equally deadly and had committed his first murder at the age of 17. He drank and he did drugs, and he had a wife he never saw living somewhere in Queens.
These are two of the four boys.
Gary, huh? What are they talking about?
Talking about Reagan's speech.
Order those two men some drinks and put on my tab. Tell them that Republicans are not welcome in Hell's Kitchen, and either a political conversion or a change of conversation is in order.
Hey, they respected it. That's probably a good decision. I mean, imagine if they had said no.
Order something for me. I gotta go to the bathroom.
Which of the two kids are these? Oh, God. Oh, my gosh. I just got goosebumps a little bit. This is not gonna be good.
Can I help you with something, Chief?
Not right now. Enjoy the rest of your meal.
Holy crap, man. This is not going to be good for him. Oh, really, it's not going to be good for any of them here.
Take a look at the guy at the table. Take a good look.
Oh my gosh. He's done, man. Pouring his beer in a cup? Hey! Hey, that... she's in The Sopranos. Tony Soprano's sister. Oh, God. That kind of pulled me out of the moment a bit. Made me happy. But this is gonna get ugly. Oh, gosh. Oh,
boy. Hello. It's been a long time.
Who the f*** are you guys? Hey, who the f*** asked you to sit down?
You know, I thought you'd do a lot better, you know? You know, with all that training, all that time you put in, just to end up watching someone else's money?
I'm asking now for the last time, what the f*** do you want?
Why don't you take your time? It'll come to you. I could see how you might forget us,
yeah.
We were just something for you and your friends to play with.
It's a little harder for us to forget. You gave us so much more to remember.
Dude. Oh, man.
You're looking at John Riley and Tommy Marcano.
John and Tommy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right. That was a long time ago.
That's all you can say.
So how you been?
Yeah, we ain't kids now.
So how you been?
So what do you want?
What I've always wanted is to watch you die.
You f***ed up.
Dude. Oh my God, it's been a while since I felt this tense in a movie.
You were scared little pricks, but I tried to make you tough. I tried to make you hard.
Oh, I had you all wrong then, though. So all this time I thought you just liked f***ing and beating up little boys.
You two motherfuckers are going to burn in hell.
Yeah, and after you.
Did that hurt, Nox?
Oh my God. Dude, they are... They took their time with this. Holy crap, man. Wow. Oh my God. I don't feel bad for him. I don't feel bad for him, but that really had me tense.
Sorry, should've made those brisket sandwiches to go.
Holy crap, man. They don't even care that there's witnesses. Let me rephrase from earlier. I said... It's been a while since I've been this tense in a movie. Aside from horror movies, because horror movies, if it's a good one, it'll always make me feel that way. But it's very rare that in, you know, like a drama movie like this, it makes me feel like how I felt in that moment when they were sitting next to, sitting at the table with him. Oh my God. That was something else, man. What a moment.
John Riley, how do you plead?
Not guilty, Your Honor.
Thomas Marcano?
Not guilty, Your Honor.
You are hereby held without bail.
In all the years since Wilkinson's, we had never once spoken to each other about what had happened there.
Jason Patrick.
We drifted together, always wondering if that moment would arrive that would force us to deal with the past.
That makes sense now, because I can now tell, recognize that that was Jason Patrick's voice doing the narration.
One down, Jakes.
One what?
One Sean Noakes.
Noakes?
Man, that was a really great moment too, with the transition there to the subway line, because just hearing Noakes' name, that's like mentally the revulsion he got probably from hearing that name. So not only was it a good transition point, but it's almost like a representation of mentally what he felt right after hearing them say his name.
At the time of Noakes' shooting, Michael was working as an assistant New York district attorney.
There he is, Mr. Pitt.
So what did they say?
What?
John and Tommy, what did they say?
It's a little cloak and dagger, isn't it, Mike?
He said one down, Shakes. One down.
Yeah, they hired Danny Snyder's lawyer, is that right?
King Benny's been moving one of his lawyers.
No, don't let him do that. Snyder's perfect.
Perfect, the guy's a full down drunk.
I'm telling you he's perfect. Take a walk.
Wow, this movie is going in directions I didn't expect.
Prosecute John and Tommy in an open court.
What are you, f***ing nuts?
Just hear me out.
What?
Call in sick and save your life, counsel.
I'm not taking this case to win.
Oh. Wow.
What does that mean?
It means it's payback time.
They can't know the history of these kids then.
It's begun. It's messy. It's not how I had it planned, but here it is.
They can't know that they're friends.
You read The Count of Monte Cristo lately? I read a little bit of it every night. I read words like revenge, sweet lasting revenge, payback time.
What are you saying, Mike?
I'm saying it's time for all of us to get a taste. I'm saying it's time to put an end to this.
Oh, man. Wow. So the rest of this movie is just going to be the courtroom drama.
And the connection between John, Tommy, and Noakes?
What connection? All juvenile records are destroyed after 7 years. We were never at Wilkinson's.
Ooh. Okay, that kind of helps them.
Gotta go after the guards. I gotta get Wilkinson's. Bring it all down. Adam Styler, plainclothes cop, works narcotics in Queens. Known to shake down dealers for dope and cash. He's got a cocaine problem. Henry Addison, now works for the mayor, if you can believe that. His sexual habits haven't changed. He still likes sex with young.
How is that common knowledge?
Plan is to call Ferguson in as a character witness. Get him talking about his best friend, Sean Noakes.
Mike, sure you want to go this way? I mean, we buried this a long time ago.
You still sleep with the light on?
Come on, man. Monte Cristo. Words like revenge. It's gonna happen.
John and Tommy, do you ever know anything about this?
Nah, to play better in court if they don't know.
And this is why the cloak and dagger type stuff. Because they can't know that there's a connection between them.
Michael's plan relied heavily on Hell's Kitchen to deliver information and keep quiet. Both were skills the neighborhood had in abundance.
That's right. What did I say at the beginning? They take care of their own issues.
The plan depended on keeping Michael alive, which meant that word had to get to John and Tommy's killing crew that he was not an open target. After this night, Michael would not be available to any of us. The only time we would see him would be in court.
Got four witnesses who saw the shooting and are willing to testify. I gotta get that number down.
I'll talk to King Benny.
What's that? What does that mean? He's gonna get those people to not testify. Threaten them?
You gotta guess one for our side. Witness who put John and Tommy somewhere else on the night of the murder.
Don't they got a name for that?
Judge would call it perjury.
And what are we calling it?
A favor.
Bring Danny Snyder to see me.
They have a lot of resources to help them with this.
Can't do this now, and you gotta know that. It's been a long time for me.
Of course it's Dustin Hoffman.
I had only 4 cases last year. You know how many I won? None. In 2 of them, I think the jury blamed me personally. I wasn't planning on taking this to trial, sir.
Well, your plans have been changed.
You know, if I could just kind of mention how this applies to me personally. I work with attorneys in my job, my full-time job. And I'm not an attorney myself, but I've learned a lot being in this job, you know, and what he was just saying about, I never planned on going to trial. I just was planning on pleading this. Well, for me, in my job, they try to settle before things go to trial. And if it does go to trial, they usually, if it's a big enough firm, they have trial attorneys who are better than them who will pick up at that point. But I guess when you're an attorney who doesn't have a large firm, you know, if you're going to trial, there's no other better person. in your firm. You have to take that case to trial. And he's just not up to par, up to task. He's a drunk, they said, right?
I am afraid that I'll make a mistake. You don't want to take that risk.
Life is risk.
I'm sorry.
Life is risk.
Life is a risk.
You're going to be given the answers and the questions. All you have to do is read. Don't drink. Don't lose.
What if I do lose?
And you go down for the dirt nap.
Oh, my gosh.
Never heard that expression before.
I'm sure you have.
I'm not really cut out for this anymore. I mean, a guy gets hit by a bus and sues. I like that. Some lady
likes ambulance chasing.
Slips in a supermarket. I'm with her.
Those are the kind of situations that I deal with. The part about slipping in a supermarket, general liability type claims, that's my world. That's what I do. Except I'm on the side of the defense. By the way, most of these claims that I see are BS. The people who make these claims are usually full.
Along with my alcohol problem, I have a slight drug problem. Nothing big, just
go away.
Oh my gosh. That was so nonchalant when he said, you go down for the dirt nap.
Sleepers. Sleepers was a strict name for anyone who spent time in a juvenile facility.
Sleepers. Okay. I was wondering if we were ever going to make sense of that title.
We need you to pull a few strings, fat man.
No, you got caught on this. You looking straight as serious. I'm talking real jail, the big house.
Had fire hydrant. It's like a symbol of their innocence.
You and the lawyer have a chance to get out.
There's no choice, not for us.
I guess they had to tell some people. They had to tell King Benny what happened to them.
Carol, she still lived in the neighborhood and was a social worker in the South Bronx. Her concern for us was undiminished by the passing years.
Oh, there's Minnie Driver.
Mug me or marry me, Shakes. I'm too tired for anything else.
Yeah, she's beautiful.
You look tired.
Thank you.
Last Tango in Paris. I've never seen that.
He went in there and he asked for the case. Now you tell me, what the hell kind of friend is that?
The best kind. The kind will throw away everything to help his friends.
Yeah. I'm surprised that no one has, like, asked him to recuse himself being the prosecution. Just for the fact of knowing them as when they were kids.
Couldn't touch him.
Ooh, Michael?
He couldn't even breathe on him. After a while, it just gets easy to let it go.
You still love him?
I don't think about his shakes. If I did, I'd say yes.
But you with John now.
As much as anybody can be with John. Man, I know it's not the boy you remember. Why didn't you ever ask me out?
I didn't think you'd say yes.
Well, you were wrong, Shay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, go ahead, say it.
You work at social services. You got files. You got access to files. And from time to time, we're gonna need some information.
Yeah, sure. Whatever.
Wait. What?
What do you want? You want information? What? You want me to get the files? I get the files, you know?
He was looking for something else, buddy.
You still visit John? Don't tell him anything. The more he thinks this thing's hopeless, the better it might work.
Shakes, what is this about?
You haven't... I thought he already explained it to you.
Now you only got two witnesses who are gonna testify. Two others changed their minds.
So that still leaves a couple in the booth.
For now. When you were sent away, I was always sorry I couldn't do more for you.
Now's your chance.
I will bring witnesses to the stand who will confirm they were there on that deadly night.
So John and Tommy think he's actually there to put him behind bars. This is quite a plan. Hey, he's with his pops.
It's nice when you come around. That's
one of my favorite foods right there. Spaghetti. Spaghetti is one of my favorite foods, and the other one is all of Chinese food.
I went down to the courthouse. I saw John and Tommy and that.
Well, what was the chicken?
Oh. Nothing.
But you're doing good, right?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Good.
What a relationship there. Happy you come around, but I don't really care what you have to say. Oh, yeah. Are we going to see Father Bobby at all?
When are you going to let us hear you pray?
What are the chances that four guards would, coming from different walks of life, don't know each other, would all be, you know, homosexual? But not that the thing about them being gay is the issue. The issue is obviously that they were assaulting kids. I don't care that they were gay. Or bi. I guess they could be bi as well.
I was caught today.
There he is.
Like the first round of a fight. Everybody just...
It's a sheep that stray that you most want back.
It's not too late, Father. We still have a chance to bring in a couple stray sheep.
Is that chance legal?
Best chances never are.
Oh. He wants him to be the witness.
Just about every base you look at, he's got it covered.
Not every base. You showed something, or else you wouldn't be here.
I just thought of something. This all goes back to the beginning of the movie, when they were playing that street game, and the other girl, her brother was in the team on the other side, and they threw the game and lost it in order for her. Same thing here. You know, as an attorney, he's planning on going down voluntarily. Wow. How about that? They're coming full circle with that.
So what is it? Where do you come up short?
We need a witness.
So you figured if you had a priest, it would be perfect. So you're asking me to lie.
Mm-hmm.
You swear to God and then lie.
I'm asking you to save two of your boys.
He did it before for him when he went into Wilkinson.
Did they kill that guard?
Yes.
So what they said is true. They walked in and they killed him.
Yes.
I think I need a drink.
You said if there was ever anything really important, I could come to you, ask you.
I was thinking more along the lines of Yankee tickets. What about the life that was taken, Shakes? What's that worth?
To me, nothing.
Why not? Tell me.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you gotta tell him. You owe him that if you're asking him to do this.
Father Bobby was going to be involved. He deserved to know what he was getting into. I thought that Carol needed to know as well.
Oh, yeah, she doesn't know either.
I told him about the torture, the beatings, and the rest.
John used to wail at night, hearing all that down the hall.
This is good. I'm glad he got to tell them. These are pretty important people in his life. They deserve to know. This is a great shot. Close up on Father Bobby's face while he's absorbing all this horrible information. Wow, this is a really great shot. They really hung on it too. He's absorbing this.
I got a decision to make. I only pray it's the right one.
It will be, Father. Whichever way you go.
Carol has a better understanding of her four friends, and her husband, too, John.
Did you see the two men as they approached the table where Mr. Noakes was sitting?
I noticed it, yes.
Are the two men you saw in McHale's in this room today?
Yes, they are. They're sitting right over there.
You stated that you only had wine to drink with dinner.
Yes, a bottle of red Chianti.
Did you have anything to drink at lunch?
Yes, I did. Probably some wine.
Mm-hmm. I see what you're doing.
Probably two glasses.
And did you,
He would have never thought of these questions on his own if they weren't written down for him.
Oh. What time, did you have lunch?
About 1:30.
Would you say that, four glasses of wine and a martini within a six-hour period is a lot for you to drink?
Yes, it is, yes.
Uh-huh.
A lot for me, too. I can't even, like, one glass of wine in a meal. I can't go for a second. Not because I can't handle the alcohol, but I'm just too full from eating.
Did you really, really look?
I glanced at them when I walked by, but I did see them.
Glanced?
I saw them.
Did you glance at them through the eyes of a very frightened woman who maybe had too much to drink?
This is crazy. This is all planned out. He has his objections planned, all of it.
Nick Davenport was with Eternal Affairs. He was ambitious and wanted to make captain before he hit 40.
Christ almighty.
So you got enough for a conviction?
That ain't up to me. That's up to a jury.
Show the jury this. About 3 weeks ago, the body of a drug dealer named Indian Red Lopez was found in an alley. This is the gun that killed him.
Well, what's behind door number three?
The prints on the gun belong to Adam Styler.
Mm.
Hey, do me a favor, would you? If I ever make it onto your shit list, give me a call. Give me a chance to apologize.
Well, was that two down? Two down shakes?
Did you ever think of becoming a cop?
And meet the good guys?
Ooh. Don't diss the guy, man. He's helping you out.
Amen.
Ooh. Is he gonna let him know in this moment? Does that mean I'll do it?
If the plan worked, it would be everyone's success. If it failed, the fault would fall to Michael.
And they don't know. So not only would the fault fall on him, but they might say screw King Benny and go after him.
I didn't see it, but I know it.
If you didn't see the
defense... He's an artist, man. He's good. Oh, that's the kid that Father Bobby said go to that art class, huh? More cloak and dagger here.
Shakes met with Father Bobby 2 weeks ago. He hasn't heard from him since.
It's not an overnight decision for him.
What if he doesn't testify?
And then we got a very serious problem.
Have Shakes talk to Father Bobby again.
Have him tell him the whole story. He'll know what that means.
He already has.
What?
He's already told him.
I heard everything, Michael. If only you told me. If you could have talked. Maybe.
It would have been different, possibly, but at least maybe you understand. Oh, he just pulled a Houdini. Touched some hair and pulled a Houdini. I know it's sad, but... Oh. What the fuck? That was such a weird moment. I was gonna say, I know it's sad, but at least you have an understanding of why things didn't work out now. What he had to go through.
This guy Addison, who works for the mayor. He don't want nobody to see pictures of him they shouldn't see.
How much does he owe?
$8,000 with a heavy vic. I paid that off.
My.
Addison's debts belong to me now.
Oh.
You hate debts.
I hate Addison.
What does this
all
mean?
We're in the dirty end of the field now. That's where I play. And I like to play alone. You're a nice kid. You always will. Don't let this change it.
Yeah. He's going to deal with that guy himself then. Let's just say I don't think he's going to be repaying that debt. Not financially anyway.
Eddie Robinson took the street name Little Caesar. As he made his way up the ranks of the lucrative drug trade. He had a 12-year-old son in a private school in upstate New York.
Oh, man. Oh, this guy's in the show The Wire. One of the best shows I've ever seen in my life.
I want you to give me some money.
How long before you pay it back?
I ain't paying it back. Somebody else's. Your little brother knew him.
Rizzo!
Rizzo?
Mm-hmm. Henry Addison was a guard in an upstate reform school.
Count out $8,000, put it in an envelope.
Wow.
He owes you something more than money.
He owes you your brother.
Nothing worth more than the green. What's this guy owe that means more than dollars?
He owes you Rizzo. He's the man that killed your brother.
Wow.
They said he died of pneumonia.
They said.
Not just him, though. I mean, obviously you can't go for Noakes now, but...
So Ralph Ferguson is a Sunday school teacher. I don't know, Counsel. What you're asking is highly unusual.
I understand that, Your Honor. Again, I need to put a face to the victim.
Mr. Snyder, any objections?
I don't have a problem with it.
The prosecution would like to call Ralph for...
You know when they do things like that? Like how he wants to add a character witness there? If the... Like, let's just say defense, if they say, do you have a problem with it? This is a little chance sometimes for them to negotiate. And the defense can say, okay, we're going to allow it, but we want, you know, blank. So it's a weird little mini negotiation within the trial. This must be hard for them to see him even there. All four of them.
We were great friends. It would be hard to find a better friend.
Would you say you were his best friend?
I was his closest, that's for sure. He was a good man. He was too good to be shot dead by a couple of street punks.
Objection, Your Honor. Statement is one of opinion, not fact.
He was asked his opinion.
Overruled. Please proceed.
Again, all of these objections already planned out.
And your function was what at this juvenile facility?
Standard stuff. Keep the boys in line. Make sure they got to their classes on time. Put them down for the night. Nothing exciting.
Oh, man. Their blood is boiling on this part. This line of questioning.
Were any of the boys hit by any of the guards at any time at the Wilkerson home?
I'm sure that something like that may have happened. It was a big place.
Mm-hmm.
Did you or Mr. Noakes ever hit any of the boys under your care?
Okay, you've paused too long. You've paused too long, man.
A few of the boys who we considered to be discipline problems were hit on occasion.
A fist, open hand, kick.
Nightstick.
Baton, maybe.
Or a baton.
It's a lot of power to have over a boy, isn't it?
It came with the job, sir.
Did torture come with the job?
Oh my god, this is so good. He thought he was coming there just to be a character witness. Didn't know he would be put on the spot with this stuff. Oh, this is great. I don't feel bad for him at all. These pauses, you're saying your answer by not speaking there.
Boys were tortured, weren't they, Mr. Ferguson?
Define torture.
If it has to be defined.
Cigarette burning.
The R word.
Random beatings. Solitary confinement with no food and no light.
The S-A words. S assault.
Who tortured them?
Guards.
Which guards?
I can't remember all of them.
Remember one.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Was there ever any sexual abuse at the Wilkerson home for boys?
God, these pauses are killing him. If you're gonna pause that long, you might as well just say yes.
I heard that there was.
I'm not asking what you heard. I'm asking what you saw.
Yes, I saw it. And you're gonna say Sean Noakes. Hopefully you'll say yourself.
I saw.
Did you and Sean Noakes ever force yourself on any of the boys? Did you and Sean Noakes ever any of the boys at Wilkinson home?
Wow.
Counselors, approach.
Approach the bench. This is a... I only have one thing I don't like about this. It's coming too easy. It's coming too fast. This should have been dragged out a little bit more. It shouldn't have been this easy to pry it out of him.
What the hell is going on here? I guess I called the wrong count to win this. Now it's blown up in your face.
Okay, so they did drag it out a little bit more. That's good.
Would your ex-wife ever leave Sean Noakes alone with your child?
There would be no reason for that. It wouldn't come up.
Objection.
Sustained.
He's breaking, man. Say it. There we go. Guess what?
Guess what?
Yes, Sean Noakes had experiences with some boys.
Did you observe these experiences?
Yes.
Did you partake?
Did you more than observe?
I was drinking then.
Were there any other guards around during these experiences?
Yes.
On more than one occasion?
A million occasions. Yes. You know what? Good on him, man. He took being on the stand seriously. He made an oath.
You still think that Sean Noakes was a good man?
He was my friend.
A friend who abused boys he was paid to look after.
Hey, you're not going home now, buddy. I'm glad he took it seriously. He didn't lie. He did it first, but they got him.
I want this to be over. I want this to be over.
They took a huge chance, though, on him. He could have easily, you know, just said no and lied about everything.
Mr. Ferguson. If I were you, I wouldn't stray too far from home. People will want to talk to you. Do you understand?
Oh, okay. He does get to leave.
Little Caesar, who always kept a picture of his dead brother in his breast pocket, called in to Henry Addison alone.
Ooh.
It was a loan Addison couldn't afford to pay back.
That's right. That's what I was saying. This is not a loan he'll be able to pay back. Not with money. When the plane passes, I bet... You'd think you would not want to have the headlights on until after the plane goes by.
Madam Styler. He was quickly arrested and charged with the shooting death of the Queen's drug dealer and 8 counts of corruption and bribery.
You know what's funny about the guy who took the stand, Ferguson? He, in this movie, he's in a juvenile detention center as a prison guard. And in the show Oz, he also is a guy in charge of a prison, one of the blocks in the prison. Who sings this? It's been a while since I heard this song.
Tonight he came through big. He's not half bad.
He said drunk, but he is not a fool.
We only win when John and Tommy walk.
God is for uptown people with suits, money, lawyers with 3 names. If you got cash, you can buy court justice. But on the street, justice has no price. She's blind where the judge sits, but she's not blind out here.
We need both.
Then you need a witness.
Yeah, we do. What a choice. But knowing his history and how he kind of walks along the line, at least even when they were kids, he was kind of walking along the line of what you expect a priest to do, I think he's going to do it. He's imagining them drowning. Are you going to save him from drowning? What is this? What was that? More cloak and dagger.
Your Honor, the defense calls Father Robert Carrillo.
He did. He showed up. All right. Do right by these guys. He's doing it. Oh, he's doing it.
Nothing but the truth shall help you, God.
I do.
Oh, boy. This definitely is not some Yankees tickets.
You recall where you were on the night of November 1st this past year?
I was at the basketball game at the Garden, the Knicks versus the Celtics.
Father Cabrillo, were you at the game alone?
No, I went there with two friends, John Riley and Thomas Marcano.
The two defendants?
Yes.
Don't look too surprised, guys. You're going to give this away. I mean, of course, they have no idea what's happening, but...
So then, Father, if the two defendants were with you at 8:25 at the night of the murder, they couldn't have shot and killed Sean Noakes. Isn't that correct?
Not unless they shot him from the blue seats of the garden.
You know, this... I just want to mention, too, that a little bit about my personal life and how this relates. What I think of when I see this is in some of the cases I deal with. Again, I work with defense all of the time. I'm always on the side of the defense. So if there's a plaintiff someone who makes a claim, let me put it in layman's terms. If there's someone who makes a claim and everyone knows it's BS, yet it still goes to trial, the plaintiff's counsel, and don't get me wrong, even a defense counsel, you could pay an expert to swear, to tell the truth. And you could get someone like they're doing to Father Bobby to say what you want. And if they're believable, they're believable. But at the end of the day, did they do this for money or did they do this because they have a motive? You never know, man. You never know.
Did you buy the tickets for the game, Father? Were they given to you?
No, I bought them.
Was anyone with you when you purchased the tickets?
No.
No one saw you buy the tickets?
That's right.
Did you get a receipt?
No, I didn't.
Of course, all of this is planned, too.
You care for the boys in your parish, don't you, Father?
Very much.
And there isn't anything you wouldn't do for them?
Anything in my power to do, I would make it a point.
And is it true, then, as a good father, you would want to protect them from something they shouldn't have done?
As much as I would want to protect them from something someone else said they did, yes.
Like a murder?
Yes, like a murder.
Let me get this straight, then. No one knew you were going to the game. No one saw you at the game. No one saw you buy tickets for the game. There's no record you even bought tickets. You have no receipt for the tickets. Am I correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Then how do we really know, Father? A priest wouldn't lie. Am I right?
A priest with ticket stubs wouldn't need to lie.
Oh.
I just keep the stubs.
Okay, that's what was in the envelope from the guy at the bodega. Wow.
Why do you keep the stubs?
Because you never know when someone might want more than your word.
Has anyone ever questioned your word before today?
No, no one ever has. But there's a first time for everything.
Oh my gosh, man.
I have no further questions. Thank you, Father.
Little Inception moment that I'm just now realizing on Brad Pitt's part. And same with Dustin Hoffman's part. They're actors who were acting... it's acting within acting here. You know, Brad Pitt is acting like he's disappointed, and Dustin Hoffman has to act like he's a stupid drunk attorney when you know he's quite a fantastic actor. What a moment. Look at their faces. They, John and Tommy are looking at Father Bobby just like in awe.
He didn't just testify for them. He testified against Wilkinson and the evil that had lived there for too long.
I mean, they have no choice now.
To the charge of murder in the second degree, do you find the defendant, John Riley, guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty.
Do you find the defendant, Thomas O'Connor?
Not guilty.
Thank you very much. This jury is discharged.
Yeah. I was kind of going off of a high here because of what happened, but at the end of the day, are John and Tommy good people? Far from it.
Hi, how are you? Could I get a hot dog?
Yeah. Give him two napkins.
Yeah.
Hot dog that is you could purchase with just a couple coins? 50-cent hot dog?
So what happens to you now?
What happens? I walk away. Wait a few weeks, I'll hand in my notice. After the way I handled this case, they won't be in a rush to keep you from the door.
Switch to the other side. Work as a defense lawyer. Money's better.
By the way, I don't deal with defense cases where you're defending people like murderers or anything. Those aren't... That's not in my world.
I've seen all the law I want to see. It's time for something else.
Like what?
Maybe start a hot dog stand.
I'm weary. I don't know. Maybe I'll get lucky, forget I was even there.
It would normally be a weird thing for someone this young to say that. Like, I'm weary, but with the stuff they've been through, it's a lot.
I don't know how to thank you. I can't believe you got away with it.
That was Mikey.
When I first heard he was taking the case, I was gonna have him burned. I figured he's a friend, and if you gotta be sent away on a murder rap, who better to do it?
I just thought he sucked as a lawyer. I just started feeling sorry for the bastard.
Never feel sorry for a lawyer.
Get over here, counselor. You are the real count. Alive and well, living in New York.
Kids today would say he's the goat.
Jesus. What is this, a gay bar?
Oh. It wasn't until you came in.
All the stuff they've gone through and make a joke like that. She's still technically married to him too, isn't she?
Worst quartet to ever hold a Hell's Kitchen corner.
What was that name that Shakes wanted to call?
No. Genius wanted to call the Count and his Crystals.
Nice.
That was so sweet.
Oh, that's hilarious.
One song for Carol.
Wait. Don't you guys have to go and shoot somebody?
Ooh.
No. We always got time for a song.
Oh my gosh. Oh. This is the song at the beginning.
Like a man.
On March 16th, 1984, John Riley's bloated body was found face up in a tenement building. Right next to the bottle of boiler gin that killed him. He was a suspect in 5 unsolved homicides. He was 2 weeks past his 29th birthday. Thomas Marcano died on July 26, 1985. He was shot at close range 5 times. The body lay undiscovered for more than a week.
Dang.
Michael Sullivan lives in a small town in the English countryside where he works part-time as a carpenter. He lives quietly and alone. Carol still works for a social service agency. She has never married, but is a single mother supporting a growing 12-year-old son. John Thomas Michael Martinez is called Shakes by his mother.
How about that?
It was our happy ending. And the last time we would ever be together again.
Wow. What they could have been, you know, had this never happened to them. Especially Tommy and John. Wow, man. What a film.
The future lay sparkling ahead, and we thought we would know each other forever.
New York State Division of Youth Corrections states that the conditions depicted in the reform school did not and do not exist in any center for juveniles. Nothing in their records supports the charges. The District Attorney's Office of Manhattan declares that no such trial ever took place. They further deny any knowledge of the incidents depicted in this movie. Lorenzo Carcaterra states that names, dates, and places were changed. He stands by his story. Oh, man. Well, we just got done watching Sleepers. What an awesome movie, man. That was awesome. While it might have been a bit predictable, it was still good. It was still riveting. And they wanted it that way, you know. It was written to where you knew what the steps were going to be. You knew the plan ahead of time. It's kind of like the viewer had an insider's perspective. They were a fly on the wall for all this planning. But despite that, this was still riveting. You were still rooting, you know, for John and Tommy in the end there. But, you know, I have some criticisms of this, but let me just talk about the good things first. First off, let me just say right off the bat, I really enjoyed this film. I would recommend this, except not to my girlfriend. This would have destroyed her. You know, I made her do a reaction with me to Saving Private Ryan, and this one, she would not like this movie. Not because she doesn't feel for them, but she doesn't like movies that would tear her up, and this definitely would. That being said, I would recommend this movie to anyone who's into a good drama film. There was outstanding performances in this movie from everyone. You know, I think Robert De Niro, probably the standout to me was Robert De Niro's performance in this. There was a lot of scenes in here that I just thought, wow, this is why he's, you know, such a good actor. But everyone did a great job in this. Everybody. Even people like Ron Eldard, who played John. I haven't seen him in much. This might be the second thing I've ever seen him in. But he did outstanding in this also. The kids all did awesome. Brad Renfro, he was like the younger Brad Pitt. Awesome job as well. All those kids. So yeah, we had awesome acting in this. It was enjoyable. Even, you know, I was going to say, this isn't really a movie where there's any special effects that are really needed too much. But I did like when Shakes was in the solitary confinement cell and kind of imagining and seeing like the fire hydrant and then playing it on his hand like an old time black and white movie. That was a really cool effect. Even the use of using black and white to kind of show things from the past. That was a good technique there. Like when they were remembering things that happened to them, or when they were thinking about the football game they had, that was in black and white. That was a good tactic. Yeah, this was just a, if a formulaic movie in the second half, it was still a good movie, you know? And I feel like, let's jump on to some of the criticisms now. I feel like I can guess what some of the criticisms other people might have are, but let me say mine first. So I know this is based on a book, and it just mentioned like Lorenzo Carcaterra stands by his story, then, you know, everything's been changed. But I wish the court scenes had been a little bit more drawn out. Maybe that's just because I personally like that and I want to see it. So maybe not everyone agrees with that, but I thought that could have been a little bit better if there was just a little bit more fight to get everything that they wanted to in the end there. Another criticism, it has to do with Tommy and John. So, you know, I feel like there's some, I can guess what some of the criticisms with this movie are. And I think one of them would be that some people would be like, why are you rooting for these guys? They're killers. They're not good people. And I understand that, you know, I can kind of see both sides of it. Like, yes, I was rooting for them while I was watching this. And I even said after the trial, you know, after Father Bobby testified, that I was like, oh, I'm just now kind of coming back down to earth that these are not good people. Well, to those people who say, why are you rooting for them? They're bad people. I think this story was self-aware of that. And later, after they, when they were having their final meal together, before some of them passed away, it did show that, you know, John and Tommy did pass away. So they lived a lifestyle that, you know, like I said in the beginning, if you choose to do something, you got to be ready to pay the consequences. And I said that multiple times in the beginning half of, you know, half of this movie. So yeah, to the criticism that this movie might get where people are like, yeah, you know, I don't, why would they choose to save two murderers? What's the point? They're bad people. They got what they deserved. So what is this movie? What is, like, what do you take away from this? What kind of story is this? It's a story about revenge. You know, is it always legal revenge? No. It's crossing both lines, legal and illegal. I think the movie basically explained that when, I forgot the guy's name, the guy who, the bigger gentleman who was like the owner of that bodega, him, Shanks, and Carol were sitting outside that basketball court and they were talking to each other. And, you know, the bodega guy was saying like, hey, if you need a lawyer, that's for the rich people. You need like street stuff. Jesus Christ, I can hear someone like spinning out their tires. There's an empty parking lot across the street from where I live. So annoying. Anyway, the point I was making is that moment of the movie encapsulated, you know, what this movie is essentially all about. It's about revenge and needing to go both avenues to get there, legally and illegally. It kind of fascinating to see how that played out too. And I'm guessing also that a lot of the criticism that this movie might get would be for people who are not okay with living in the gray, or realizing that, you know, the world is gray. People who see the world as black and white would probably hate this movie. But for me, I feel like I'm someone who lives in the gray. And yeah, this was a great revenge tale. And Tommy, like I said, Tommy and John were not good people, but revenge is revenge. And that was kind of the whole story with what Hell's Kitchen is all about too. Vigilante kind of justice. You know, there's supposed to be eye for an eye, then we're going to take that eye. So, yeah, great film. I think I've said everything I need to about this one, but great to have another courtroom drama on the channel, too. I've only ever had one movie I reacted to that was a courtroom drama, and that was A Few Good Men. So it's good to have another one on the channel. I love seeing that stuff so much. And it's weird because, you know, I work with this stuff, but I still like to see it. But anyway, I think I'll wrap this one up. But yeah, Kay, you had a great request here, so thank you. This is a movie that passed me up, you know, and I the name sounded familiar, but it's good to, you know, finally have seen this one. There's so many big names in this, and everyone did a great job. I feel like this was such a a big movie just based on this cast back then, and I guess I was just too young to have really been aware about this one. 1996, I think I was a freshman in high school and didn't really watch movies like this at such a young age, you know. That would have not been my style. So, yeah, glad I got to get this on the channel. Great film. Thanks for the request. I'm going to wrap this up, but if you guys are still here, thanks for taking the time out of your day to hang out with me. I hope you got something out of this reaction. If you have any other movies or shows you want me to check out, let me know in the comments, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.